If you've ever been captivated by the beauty of topographic textures, the intricate lines and patterns that create depth and movement, and wondered how to incorporate that stunning aesthetic into your poster designs, then you're in the right place. Topographic textures are not just visually striking, they add an engaging layer that can transform your posters from ordinary to extraordinary. Whether you're promoting an event or showcasing a product, these textures will give your designs a fresh and organic look. So whether you're a seasoned designer or just starting out, stick around because this tutorial is going to help you infuse some incredible topographic flair into your poster designs. So these are some fictional music festival posters I created earlier. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to use the tools of Illustrator to create this poster design specifically, and later we will look at how we can make some variations. So let's get into it. So here I am in Illustrator, and these are some posters I created earlier. For these, I have gone with a really simple yet striking approach. These poster designs are for a music festival, so the use of topographic texture works well to symbolize sound waves. Here I'm working with flat, high contrasting colors, where the black sits on top of the solid, luminous colors, which creates a really solid and impactful design aesthetic. This color scheme feels reminiscent of the 90s rave scene. And to add a more dynamic quality to them, I have created a set of posters with different content. And for the layout, I have used a simple 6-column grid to align and contain my elements with a nice thick margin space for all the elements to breathe and feel really clear and legible. If you want to take a look at these poster designs and study the process, you can access this Illustrator document in the download folder, which comes as part of the poster design ebook. If you want to learn more, you can check the link in the description. So to begin, I'm going to create a new document. I'll create an A3 document set to portrait with a 3mm bleed. With my new canvas set, I want to create a decent margin space around the poster canvas. I'll draw a shape to fit my canvas area, come up to Object, down to Path, hit Offset Path, and type in -20. With my new shape, I'll come back up to Object, down to Path, I'll hit Split into Grid, and set the columns to 6 and the gutter to 10, and click OK. With my shapes still selected, I'll come up to View, down to Guides and hit Make Guides. I'll come into the Layers panel, click on the layer name, call this Grid, and that's my grid sorted. Now, when I work in poster design, I generally sketch on paper first to get a rough idea of the sort of layout I want to go with. However, it's not always the case that I'll do this. And for those of you watching, you may or may not sketch your ideas first before you design your posters. However, I still think it's important to think through a layout before bringing in all the visual elements. So if I have not thought about my layout before starting on the computer, I'll begin with a quick wireframe. Now, any of you familiar with web design will know that this is a process that a lot of web designers will use. Wireframing is a very common process in website design, where one will move shapes around to get a feel of a composition before committing to visual elements. This process can be equally beneficial for poster design. What I'll do here is just push around some shapes just to get a feel of where I can compose my elements and get an initial impression of a composition. This will create a loose guide which can make the whole process easier. So here I have placed in some rectangle shapes within my column grid, and I've placed these in their own layer called wireframes. Now, I could spend a while creating lots of different permutations here, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'll keep it simple. Here I have just placed some blocks down and I feel this is working. In the background, I have a large space where I want to place my texture, and on top and around, I have some smaller blocks in the column grid of where I could place some other content. So once I have a wireframe I'm satisfied with, I can start thinking about working with visual elements. And in this instance, I'm going to start with the typography. So looking back at my final poster design, we can see how the type is composed and the font choice I used. For this poster design, I'm going to use the font Tandeel. This is a really nice sans serif typeface. It's a condensed typeface, it looks great in all caps, and I find the quality of the numbers are visually bold and interesting. Now, this is an Adobe font. If you have an Adobe account, you should be able to sync this font, or in the content doc, you will see a page with a link to sync it. This is a content doc that has been created to help you follow along with this tutorial. If you want to get hold of this content deck and get access to the font, click the link in the description. Now, if you don't have an Adobe account, a really good alternative is a font called Steelfish. This has the same condensed quality of Tandeel, And again, you can grab this font from the content deck. And if you want to explore some other condensed fonts, you can also check out the GDS font book, where I have curated a list of the best free condensed fonts online. So first, I'm going to come into the layers panel, click to add a new layer, I'll name this type, and I'll put this below my grid layer. Into the content deck, I'll choose the first line of text, a magic sound journey, and back into Illustrator, I'll create a simple text frame and place this piece of text up in the top left corner. In the character panel, I have the size set to 50, the leading set to 50, the tracking set to 40, and I have applied the all caps button. So back into the content deck, for these poster designs, there is a range of words that we can put on top. So to start, I'll just choose one of them. I'll go with Echo, and back in Illustrator, I'll create another simple text frame and place this piece of text in the top right corner on top of my wireframe. For this piece of text, I wanted it to be quite large to overlap the texture below. This will just give it a more visual dynamic, crossing over the visual texture below. In the character panel, I have the size set to 375, the tracking set to 20, and I have applied the all caps button. So back into the content deck, next I'm going to place in the paragraph text. I'll select all the paragraph text in the content deck, and back into Illustrator, this time I'll place the text into a paragraph frame and place it in the bottom left. Now, for this paragraph, we can see there are two types of formatting. For the header, I've put this in bold in all caps, and below I have the text in lowercase in the regular font. For the paragraph text, in the character panel, I have the size set to 25, the tracking set to 20, and this time I have not applied the all caps button. And for all the type, I have the leading set to 30. When working with paragraph text, make sure that there is a nice balance between the title above and the paragraph text below for added contrast and legibility. So next to the paragraph text, here we have this wireframe block. My thinking here was I could fit the date and have it quite nice and bold. So back into the content deck, I'll select the date, back into Illustrator, I'll create another simple text frame and place this piece of text down here to fill this block space across two columns. Now to get a nice balance here, I'll bring down a guide from the top and place it above the paragraph type and adjust the type to match the height of the paragraph block and fit it nicely across two frames. In the character panel, I have the tracking set to 40 and here I've simply scaled the type up to fit snug inside the two column width. If I zoom out and toggle off the wireframe layer, we can see that this is beginning to look quite neat. Now, if I turn the wireframe back on, now I want to get some text in the middle of this space. Back into the content deck, I'll select the words vibes in the mountain, and back into Illustrator, I'll create a simple text frame and place this piece of text in the middle. Now, on this occasion, I'll be sure to place a hard return after the word the to put mountain on a second line. In the character panel, I have the size set to 115, the leading set to 110, tracking set to 220, and I have applied the all caps button. So now I just have one more space to fill down in the bottom right. For this, I wanted to add a bit of fun to the poster. And since the theme is about an electro music festival, I thought I'd bring in the classic acid house rave face. So into the download folder, into the images folder, into the icons folder, I have four EPS files. On this occasion, I'll open the happy face EPS icon in Illustrator, copy and paste it into my poster. I'll position this in the bottom right, align right to the column, and touch the guide above, so the height of this icon is now matching the height of the paragraph and the date. So if I zoom out and turn off the guides, we can see this is looking really neat. So the next thing I'm going to do is bring in the topographic texture. And for this, I'm going to choose from a range of topographic textures I have created earlier. Now, for the sake of this tutorial's length, I'm not going to go into too much depth about how to create this effect. In one of my previous videos, I dedicated an entire video tutorial to how to create a topographic texture like this easily in Adobe Illustrator. If you want to know more about how to do this in Illustrator, then you can check the link in the description to watch a more in-depth tutorial. So here I have some topographic textures as part of an image pack you can use in your own work, which is included in the download folder. So into the download folder, into the texture pack folder, into the topographic folder, open the topographic texture Illustrator file, and from here I can select a topographic texture. On this occasion, I'm liking this one here, so I'll copy this into my poster doc. In the layers panel, I'll click to add a new layer. I'll call this texture and place this below my type layer, and I'll paste in my topographic texture. So this texture is pretty organic. There's lots of shapes, and right now it's overlapping the canvas area. So next I want to crop this. So I'll bring back the visibility of the wireframes and we can see below the box area I had planned for my texture. I'll unlock the wireframe layer, select the rectangle shape and copy. I'll lock the wireframe layer and toggle the visibility off. On my texture layer, I'll paste this rectangle shape and set the fill color to white. So right now, the texture is made up of individual strokes and they are currently grouped. So this is going to make it easy to mask them all. With the white box selected and the stroke texture selected, I'll come into the transparency panel and click Add Mask. If I want to toggle the size of my texture within the crop space, I'll click the lock icon between the left and right thumbnail in the transparency panel. I'll click on the left thumbnail, and this will allow me with the selection tool to click my texture and move it around or scale up or down to fit inside the frame, like so. Once satisfied, I'll set the stroke size to 0.75 and I'll click the lock icon in the transparency panel, click on the left thumbnail and click off to deselect. Now, if I press Command plus 0 on Mac or Control plus 0 on PC, we can fit the canvas area to the height of the work area and get a good look at the overall layout. And that's looking pretty neat with everything sitting nicely inside the column grid. So with my initial composition sorted, I can now start to think about working with color. So looking back at the final poster designs, we can see that the color approach for these is very straightforward. For this design approach, I'm using a simple background solid color to contrast really well with the black type and texture above. Now, one practice I like to do when working with poster design in Illustrator is to duplicate my artboards. This makes it easier to focus on new ideas and have something to fall back to later. So in the layers panel, I'll make sure that every layer is unlocked. I'll come up to view down to guides and make sure to unlock guides. I'll press Command plus colon on Mac or Control plus colon on PC to make sure I can see my guide. Into the tools menu, click on the artboard tool, click on the artboard and drag right while holding Alt and Shift to make a duplicate. I'll come into my layers panel, create a new layer. I'll call this base and drag it to the bottom. I'll draw a solid rectangle color from the top left hand bleed line to the bottom right corner bleed line. And in the tools panel, I'll make sure that the stroke is set to transparent and I'll double click in the fill color and I'll set this to a luminous yellow with the hex value of FFFF19. On this occasion, I'll also change the word in the top right to rave. I'll press Command 0 on Mac or Control 0 on PC to fit the canvas area to the height of the work area. I'll press Command plus colon on Mac or Control plus colon on PC to toggle off the guides. And that's looking pretty neat. I'm liking this a lot. It looks very crisp, but I feel we could still add another level of fun to it. Next, I'm going to add some ink splat textures. So into the download folder, into the texture folder, open the ink splat texture Illustrator file. And you can see here, I have some fun textures. I'll pick one, copy, and back into my document, I'll come to the base layer in my layers panel, click to add a new layer and call this splat. Paste in the texture, I'll drag it onto my canvas area, scale to fit, I'll change the color to white, and now I have this really eye-catching poster where we've got this interesting background with the black visual elements above contrasting really nicely. So once you have one layout set up in Illustrator, it's so easy to create other color variations. Looking back at my final poster designs, you can see I have a range of color choices. Now I won't create all of these, but I'll show you how to create one. So using the same technique as before, I'll make sure all the layers are unlocked in the layers panel. I'll toggle on my guides, and with the artboard tool, I'll click and duplicate it to the right. And upon release, I'll have a new artboard. Here I can simply click the background and change the color. In this instance, I'll set it to a luminous green color with a hex value of 8CF80F. Back in my content deck, I'll go with another title for the poster. This time I'll go with base and type it into the top left. And here I have a different version. So using this technique, I could just duplicate the poster as many times as I like and change the color background. Now on this next version, I wanted to try something a little different. Now I've got a couple of examples, I can now explore different layouts. In this instance, I'm going to click into the center type and change this to the date. In the character panel, I have the size set to 135. The tracking set to 400, and this time I'll set the font to italics just to add a little bit more flair. Next, I'll click on the topographic texture at the bottom. In the transparency panel, I'll unlock the two layers. I'll click on the right thumbnail to access the mask layer. I'll drag this up a little to create more space below. I'll duplicate the vibes in the mountains text from the previous poster, and I'll place it down on one line and underneath the texture. In this version, I'm going to add a QR code to the bottom right. I'll also include more icons down here to sit nicely in the bottom corner as a slight detail. I can grab these from the download folder in the icons folder, place them down comfortably, and this makes a different version. Tell me which version you prefer in the comments, guys. Do you prefer the first version or the second version? So looking back at my finished poster designs, you can see that below I have another row. This time, instead of using a square shape to crop the texture, I'm using a circle. This can add a different dimension to the poster design. So back into my document, again, with all the layers unlocked, I'll press Command plus colon on Mac or Control plus colon on PC to toggle on the guides. With the Artboard tool, I'll just click on the first one, press Command A on Mac or Control A on PC to select all, press and hold Shift plus Alt and drag down, and that will copy all of the artboards. I'll lock all of the layers apart from the texture layer. I'll click and drag across every poster to select all the textures and delete them. I'll come back into the topographic texture pack and select another texture, paste it into the poster. This time I'll draw a circle in my canvas area where I want the texture to be placed. I'll set this to white and I'll use this as a layer mask to crop the texture using the same technique I showed earlier. Once I'm happy with my circle texture, I'll select the circle texture and press Command X on Mac or Control X on PC to cut, and then press Command plus Shift plus V on Mac or Control plus Shift plus V on PC, and this will paste it back in place. I'll click on each poster artboard and press Command plus Shift plus V on Mac or Control plus Shift plus V on PC, and this will paste a copy of the circle texture onto each poster in the right place. Now the last step I'll take is to adjust the typography on the type layer to balance with the circle texture. Soon I'll have a new set of posters with circle texture in the middle. So once you're happy with your artwork and you want to export ready for print, you can either export the entire document or you can export just one poster or a range. For this example, I just want to export the second poster here. So when you're ready to export, simply come up to File and click on Save as Copy. I'll name this Music Festival Poster 1, and down in the format, I'll choose Adobe PDF. Now you can export all, but on this occasion, I'll click on Range and type in 2. I'll click Save and up will pop another menu. Here, I'm going to make sure that for PDF, PDF preset, high quality print is selected. I'll make sure that View PDF after saving is checked. I'll come over to the left and click Marks and Bleeds. I'll click only on trim marks. For bleed, I'll set this to use document bleed settings and then click Save PDF. Then Illustrator will do its thing and up will pop Acrobat Reader. I'll come up to View, Zoom, Fit to Height, and now I can see the poster design exported as a PDF, ready to send on to a printer. If you notice around the outside, we can also see the trim marks, and this is where the printer will trim the poster after printing to ensure a clean cut with no white edges. Perfect. So that's how you can create a vibrant poster design using the topographic texture in Illustrator. So this brings us to the end of another poster design journey. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and most importantly, you have gained valuable knowledge to harness your creativity and you have something to show for it. Setting up a poster in this way offers so much flexibility to change your colors quickly. So I hope that this process inspires you to have a play with the topographic style and experiment with color combinations. Using this technique, you can get some really interesting results. Now, if you want to save yourself some time and use these poster design templates, you can get them as part of the poster design ebook. The poster design ebook includes crucial design theory to help you create professional poster designs with lots of design resources, more tutorials, and includes all the poster design tutorial assets for this tutorial and more. If you want to learn more, you can check the link in the description. Well, I hope you enjoyed this poster design tutorial. If you did, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell button to be notified of more tutorial videos like this in future. Now, this tutorial was created for all my members of the GDS Design School community. If you'd like to join the GDS Design School community, where we chat about design, give each other feedback, and where I set design challenges, you're all welcome to join for free. Again, the link is in the description, and I look forward to seeing you there. So until my next design tutorial, unleash your creativity, and I'll see you next time.